हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय क्लास. सो इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड सेमीकंडक्टर फिजिक्स. इन दैट सेमीकंडक्टर फिजिक्स वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द पीएन जंक्शन डायोड एंड ऑप्टिकल डायोड्स, फॉर एग्जांपल सोलर सेल, फोटो डायोड, एलईडीज एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स वी हैव फिनिश्ड. So in this class I will start the transistor. So once you complete the transistor characteristics, working of transistor, currents in the transistor and different configurations of transistor, then we'll move to the logic gates. Okay, so bipolar junction transistors. So today I'll start the bipolar junction transistors. Bipolar junction transistors. Okay, bipolar junction transistors. That means there may be two junctions will be there. Like, so this is simply a device, electronic device, which has many applications. This has replaced as a old vacuum diodes. Okay, so this has a four terminals. So logically speaking, only three terminals. Out of three terminals, one will be common for input as well as output. So if there are three terminals for me, let us make something will be common. Now you take the input will be here. That means we are putting some input voltage here, and you collect the output will be from here. Output will be from here. It has only three terminals, but still we can use as a input two terminals and output two terminals. Out of three, one will be common for both input and output. This transistor is like this. It has the two junctions. It is simply the PN junction diode and PN junction diode. So bipolar, that's why it is a bipolar. There will be a two junctions, PN junction type. So that we know already that PN junction type. PN junction. Okay. So PN junctions, there are two PN junctions. So transistors is of two things. So one is of PNP transistor and NPN transistor. Let us take a P-type material and inject N in between. There is a P and then there is a N, then there is again a P. Then NPN transistor. Let us take a N-type material and sandwich P-type material between N and M. Okay. So let us see. In this chapter, in this topic, in this transistors, we see the working of transistor, so different configuration of transistors, current equation, and finally we see the amplification of a transistor. That means it enhances the input signal. So that is amplification gain, like amplifier. Transistor will behave like an amplifier, then and feedback oscillator, feedback amplifier and transistor as an oscillator, that also we will discuss. So I'll follow the strictly NCERT book. So you go through the NCERT book. Okay, fine. So let's see. I have already ready made file will be there. I'll insert that ready made file and I'll explain that. I'm sorry. Oh, shall do. Yeah. You see here, bipolar junction transistor. Yeah, fine. What is the definition of this? The first I am going for the definition. What is the definition of this? Definition. A bipolar junction transistor or BJT is a three-terminal electronic device that amplifies the current, that amplifies the flow of current. It is a current control device. In bipolar junction transistor, electric current is due to free electrons as well as holes. That means whenever we are talking about the semiconductor, in a semiconductor, electric current is due to because of electrons as well as holes. Hole current is also there and electric current also there. So, unlike a normal PN junction diode, transistor has a two PN junction diodes. Okay, just now I explained, it has like one n-type material is sandwiched between the two p-type materials, or one p-type material is sandwiched between two n-type materials. So there is a two n-type materials are there and one p-type material is sandwiched, or otherwise there are two p-type materials, one n-type material is sandwiched. Okay. The bipolar junction transistors formed by sandwiching either n-type or p-type semiconductor layer between the pairs of opposite polarity. That's what here we have explained. So based on that, we have NPN transistor and PNP transistor. Okay, fine. So what is an NPN transistor? So p-type semiconductor layer is sandwiched between two n-type semiconductor layers, that is an NPN transistor. So what is a PNP transistor? Okay, that is common. So both PNP and NPN transistors consist three terminals. There are three terminals. First terminal is called emitter, second one is called base, another one is called collector. So that means they has something like this. There will be two similar things, this is and this will be the exactly same. This middle one will be something different. So this is called as an generally emitter, and this is called as an base, and this is known as collector. So emitter, the meaning will be which emits the free electrons or holes. Collector, which collects the charge carriers. And B, that is the base, that is something like it a bypass. So the charge carriers will bypass through that junction. The symbolical representation of the NPN transistor will be shown here. The symbolical representation of the NPN transistor: emitter, base, collector. Like this, this is the one way of representing, this is one symbolical representation of the transistor. Otherwise same thing will represent like this, like this. So first draw a circle. After drawing a circle, first draw a line vertically, that is known as the base. Now you draw the two lines which connects the surface of the circle. The vertical line generally we call as a base. The remaining two lines, one is of emitter and another one is of collector. One is of emitter, another one is of collector. Which one is emitter and which one is collector will be decided by an arrow mark. If I keep an arrow mark here, whether out of the, so it is going away from the circle, that means away either from the base or towards the base. So in case of NPN transistor, I kept the arrow away from the base. So in case of PNP transistor, I kept it is towards the base. Okay, remember, emitter always connected with that arrow. Emitter is always connected with that arrow. With collector, there is nothing as such. Okay, so be careful. So this is the transistor, symbolical representation of transistor, either NPN transistor or PNP transistor. So this is the symbolical representation. Okay, fine. So you remember, they may ask you what are the symbols for NPN transistor and PNP transistors. Okay, so let me describe one by one. What is called as an emitter? What is the meaning of an emitter? Emitter means which is the source which emits. As the name suggests, emitter section supplies the charge carriers. So emitter section is heavily doped because it has to supply the large number of carriers. Inject large number of charge carriers into the base. The size of the emitter is always greater than the base. So one thing that is important is heavily doped. And always greater than the base. Size of the emitter will be greater than that of the size of the base. Okay. So now go for the base. So what is the base? The middle layer is called the base. The base is very thin as compared to the emitter and collector. It's lightly doped. So base is lightly doped. So if it is a p-type material, we need to dope with the trivalent impurities. If it is n-type material, we need to dope with the pentavalent, but this will be lightly doped. So very thin, the size is very small. Size of the base is very small. Now go for the collector. The function of the collector, the name itself is collect the charge carriers from the emitter. So how it will be doped? It is moderately doped. So that is important. See, transistor is a device. That is, we can decide what is the nature of each and every element there, so that collectively the device will act according to our wish. So man avasaranni batti man device nu tayar chesukuntunnam. The doping level of the collector A section is between emitter and base. So that means it is moderately doped. It is not heavily doped, it is not lightly doped. But the size of the collector is always greater than the emitter and base. The size of the collector is greater than that of size of the emitter, that even greater than that of the size of base. So among all three, which is bigger, means among all three, the bigger size in the physical size, collector is a bigger. Among all, the very thin size will be the base. Among all, heavily doped will be emitter is heavily doped. So that's why the collector area in the transistor is considerably larger than the emitter area. This is because collector region has to handle more power than the emitter does. The more surface area is required for heat dissipation. So that means as it is collecting the all the charge carriers, there is more heat will be evolved because of the more power. So more power dissipation will be there, more heat will be there. So that means we keep the surface area is more, so that it will radiate, like it will dissipate the heat. Yeah, this is the golden point you're supposed to be remember here. What is this golden point? See here. In a transistor, the amplification is achieved by passing a current from a region of low resistance to a region of high resistance. So amplification, signal and amplified. Amplification means output is greater than that of input, is known as the amplification. Output is greater than that of input is known as the amplification. That may be output voltage is greater than that of input voltage, or otherwise output current may be greater than that of input current. So that is known as an amplification. This can be done if we keep the So when current achieved by passing it input current from a region of low resistance. That means input must be of low resistance. Output must be of high resistance. Okay. This golden point is supposed to be remembered. This will be asked in the objective questions. Then what will be the application of bipolar junction transistor? Then uses ENT. So this has a like nowadays in every in everywhere there is a silicon and germanium. Everywhere there are diodes, transistors, integrated circuits. So everything it constitutes. So it is not like that ki there is no element without any transistor and diodes. That is television. So anything LED, LCD, whatever it may be, mobile phones, computers, radio transmitters, audio amplifiers, and everywhere it is there. So starting from a small device to radio, to in aeroplane, in ships, everywhere there is a transistor. You cannot escape the like your life without using the transistor. So mana daily life lo mana transistor vadakunda asalu mana undane lemo. The transistor is the common, so it must be there. Okay, fine. So be careful. Yes, fine. So this is the introduction about the bipolar junction transistor. This is the introduction about the bipolar junction transistor. Yeah, now let us go for the bipolar junction operation modes. So deeni ela manam operate chestam, what are the operation modes of this device? So bipolar junction transistor can be operated in three modes. It will be operated in three modes. What are the three modes? One is known as a cutoff mode, another one is known as the saturation mode, another one is known as the active mode. So cutoff mode, saturation mode, and active mode. Let's say all these three modes. So what are all these three modes that we will discuss right now? Okay, just a second. Yeah, be careful. You just go through each and every point in the each and every point in NCRT book. You go through each and every point in the NCRT book, that is very important. So everything is explained in the NCRT book very thoroughly, and that to be our NEET examination and JE mains examination will be conducted by National Testing Agency within the domain of this NCRT books. Okay, they can't go beyond that. So that's why it is better to go through each and every corner in that book. So you there only will come to know what is each and every point, what is the meaning of cutoff region, what is the like every point, then whatever I am teaching that will be directly from the our NCRT book. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Let me take a image for you to understand cutoff region. Yeah, just a minute. I'm sorry, just a second. This you can see clearly. Like I have drawn the output voltage versus input voltage of a transistor. So output voltage ki input voltage ka graph gisanu. A graph lo manaku telustundi. I have divided into three regions. So based on the curve. So most probably we operate the most of the time it will be in the active region. The operation mode will be the active mode operation. So let me explain what is the meaning of cutoff mode, saturation mode and active mode. In order to operate the transistor in one of these regions, we have to supply a DC voltage to the transistor. So mana biasing jayali. Based on the polarity of the applied DC voltage, the transistor operates in any one of these three regions. Ante samanamu. So there will be any transistor you take here. It will be either PNP transistor or NPN transistor. So one thing will be common. Then here is the, let's say for example, input, and let's say this will be the output. So depending upon the voltage we have applied here and voltage applied we have there. So output voltage and input voltage. Let's see here. Applying DC voltage, transistor nothing but biasing a transistor. You have to bias the transistor. So cutoff mode. So I am taking an NPN transistor. So NPN transistor, let's see. You just remember some terminology will be here. NPN transistor. There is a N, there is a P, and again there is a N. So definitely it is something like one PN. This is another PN. So we call this is the junction 1. So junction of emitter base. Junction of emitter base or junction 1. And this is another junction. This is the junction of collector and base. Collector and base. There are two junctions will be there. So that's why I put here the names J1 and J2. One is between emitter and base, another one is collector and base. Let's say now I am taking NPN transistor. Now I am biasing the, like base is common I kept here. I kept the base will be common for input as well as output. Base is common. So now base emitter voltage, that is base emitter voltage. Here it is, I am connected with the positive here. So N is connected to the positive. So N is connected to the positive means, N is connected to the positive means, here is the positive, we are connecting with the positive. N connected with the positive, that is the reverse bias. Here N connected with the positive, that is reversed biased. So that means both the junctions are connected reverse bias. So they are operating the reversed bias. So both the junctions will be the reversed bias. Both the junctions are operating in the reversed bias mode. So when the both the junctions are in the reversed bias mode, let's see here. In cutoff mode, both the junctions of the transistor, both the junctions of the transistor, emitter to base and collector to base are reversed biased. In other words, if you assume the PN junction as two PN junction diodes, both the diodes are reversed biased in cutoff mode. We know that in reversed bias condition, no current flows through the device, hence no current flows through the transistor. Therefore, transistor is in a off state and acts like a open switch. When the switch is open, there is no current. So that means we know that if PN junction diode is there, if we see the IV characteristics, IV characteristics, current in the circuit and potential difference is applied. In the reverse, ideal diode will have the reverse characteristics. They have almost zero current. So that means out in the reverse bias condition, we have the current is almost zero. So but here it will have, we have the current will be like this. Exponential growth will be there in the forward bias. So in the reverse bias, current will be zero. because it have the infinite resistance. In the forward bias, it has the current. In the forward bias, it has the current. Okay. So, what is the meaning of cutoff mode? In the cutoff mode, the diodes will be connected in the reversed bias. So, you give the voltage in such a way that both will be in the reversed bias condition. So, the reversed bias condition lo undetattu ganaka mana current isthe adi cutoff mode lo. So, cutoff mode lo adi ela act chestundi final ga open switch. When in a circuit, when there is a switch is open instead of closed, obviously no current flows. So, that's why in open switch, the cutoff region, and the cutoff region, this is the cutoff region. So, this region will be the cutoff region. So, let us go to the next biasing. So, this is the cutoff mode biasing. So, the cutoff mode transistor is used in switching operation for which off application. Suppose if we want an off application, then you can use this transistor is biased in such a way that both the junctions are in the reversed bias. So, I'll not teach again what is the meaning of biasing, that you know already. Biasing means. So, for PN junction diode ki biasing chayadam, forward biasing, reversing biasing, malla chapanav samle. So, next go to the saturation mode. Saturation mode ante enti. Both the junctions of the transistor, emitter to base and collector to base are forward biased. In other words, if we assume two PN junction diodes as to mean, both the diodes are forward biased in saturation mode. So, that means both the diodes in the forward bias. So, this junction is a forward bias you check. N is connected with the negative. So, both are the forward bias. So, once both are the forward bias, then that will act like a saturation. That means we know that in the forward biased condition, circuit will allow the current without any obstruction. Current flows through the device and electric current flows through the transistor in a saturation mode. In saturation mode, free electrons flow from emitter to base as well as from collector to base. As a result, huge current flow will be there. Huge current will flow to the base of transistor. Therefore, transistor in saturation mode will be in a state and acts like a closed switch. And then exactly opposite. So, that means the saturation mode of the transistor is used in switching operation, a switch on application. And then, manakoka switch on condition low behave chayale ante, ade transistor this koni saturation mode lo ganaka manamo connect chaste, then it will act like a switch on. So, that means, so that's why transistor will behave like a switch ani antuntam. So, transistor can be used as a switch. So, not only transistor as an amplifier, even it can be used as a switch. Now, the important thing for us will be the, what is the active mode? That is important for us. Active mode is important. So, in active mode, one junction, that is emitter base junction, is forward biased and another junction, collector base junction, will be reverse biased. That means we have so anything we can take. There's a PNP diode is there. Now, this is the emitter and this is the base and this is the collector. So, this junction is the first junction, emitter base junction, and this is the second junction, collector base junction. So, now this will be is of in the forward biased condition. Now, this will be is in the reverse biased condition. Make this junction is always forward biased and make this junction is always reverse biased. Then we say that the transistor is in the active mode. So, that means out of two diodes, one diode will be forward biased and another diode will be reversed biased. Then that will be the active mode of operation. Now, let's see here. So, emitter and base junction, that is emitter and base junction, we have to maintain this junction, we have to maintain forward biased. That means N will be connected to the negative. Yes, see here, negative. And this must be of reversed biased condition. N will be must be connected to the positive. Let's see, this is the positive. That's why this is the forward biased and this will be the reverse biased condition. Okay, one is a forward biased, another one will be a reverse biased condition. Okay, fine. I hope students you understood this clearly. If there any doubt, I can explain once again. I hope it is clear. That's things are so explained very easily. So that means emitter and base junction is always forward biased and collector and base junction is always reversed biased when the transistor is in active mode. So that means most of the cases we require this active mode operation. Okay, fine. That active mode operation used for the amplification of the current. So they may ask in the questions, so what is the mode we use for amplification of the current? So we use in the active mode of operation for the amplification of current. Okay, fine. So from the above discussion, we can say that transistor works as an switch, maybe in on condition, off condition. So on condition in saturation mode, off condition in cutoff mode. It works as an amplifier for active mode. So that means be aware of what is a, like transistor will be of either NPN transistor or PNP transistor. So whatever it may be, whether it is NPN transistor or PNP transistor, it will have the two junctions. So three terminals, emitter, base, collector. So three terminal device, this is one terminal and this is another terminal and this is another terminal. So now you must be careful about, like, one will be common of course because we need the four terminals, two for input and two for output. So this will be the first junction we call as the emitter and base, and this will be the another junction we call as the collector and base. So remember always, this will be always forward biased. This is always a forward biased. And remember, this is always a reverse bias. So one is a forward biased, another one will be in the reverse biased for an active mode. So active mode. For amplification purpose, view the transistor in an active mode only. Okay, fine. I think there is no issues here so far. Yeah. Let's go for the another file. So working of NPN transistor and PNP transistors we see. So go for the working of, like, so complete details about the NPN transistor. So complete details about the NPN transistor, that we will discuss here. So NPN transistor, NPN transistor means where we have the N type of semiconductor material, that P type material will be sandwiched in between them, that will be the NPN transistor. The symbol will be is shown here. There is an emitter, base and collector. So where emitter, there is an arrow, that arrow is from base to emitter. There is a, like, base to emitter, there is an arrow. So that means in the diagram we can see here, there is a diagram from base to emitter. That is a, here the diagram from base to emitter. What is that diagram? Arrow mark, what is that? That we will see. Okay. So P-type material will be sandwiched on all those things we know. Now that important thing will be is of the working of an NPN transistor. What is the working of an NPN transistor? So we see the working of NPN transistor. Working of unbiased NPN transistor. That means don't put any voltages. Unbiased means we are not keeping any voltages. So everybody knows in case of N-type material, what will be the majority carriers? In N-type material, majority carriers are the electrons, minority carriers are the holes. In p-type material, majority carriers are holes and minority carriers are electrons. So there will be two things we need to discuss. One is diffusion current, another one will be the drift current. So diffusion current is due to the majority carriers. So drift current is due to the minority current. So minority carriers. So drift of an electron is forcefully happens. So diffusion will happen because of the number density is more. So this will happen because of that junction electric field. Junction or internal electric fields. So this is because of the density variations. Density variation. Whenever there is a density variation, then the diffusion process will occur. So high concentration to low concentration. Okay. Now let's see the working of NPN transistor. So when no voltage is applied to a transistor, it is said to be unbiased. Ante manu em apply cheyakapothe dan unbiased ani antam. So majority carriers, minority carriers nenu meeku explain chesanu. Idi clear ga meeku explain chestundi. So this color will be the free electrons, and this color will be the silver color, gold color will be free electrons, and silver color will be holes. So negative ions will be there. That is the negative ions. When something is ready to accept the electrons, that is the negative ions. The positive ions, after donating, it will become the positive ion. Okay, after donating, it will become the positive ions. Okay, so when we add the pentavalent impurity, so once it donates an electron, then it will become the positive. So when we add the trivalent impurity, it is ready to accept the electrons. That way it has a negative ions, we call it is. Remember, ions are heavy, they are stable. So finally, there will be two junctions will be formed. So this is the junction one will be here and the junction two will be here. Junction 1 and junction 2 will be here. Yeah. So we know that the majority charge carriers, free electrons, and always try to move from high concentration region to low concentration. So ikkada manaku N region anedi high concentration of electrons, P region anedi high concentration of holes. But emitter anedi heavily doped kabatti we have majority of the electrons will be here. Majority of the electrons will be here. So therefore the free electrons at the left side of N region, that is emitter lo unnatvanti free electrons ekkada move avutai, collector lo unnatvanti electrons experience a repulsive force from each other. As a result, the free electrons at the left side and right side of the will move into the P region. So endukani manam ikkada deenni forward bias chestunnam. Forward bias chestunnam ante enti, we are connecting, suppose it is like nothing will be there, so nothing will be biased really. Then I am just explaining the so how the depletion region will be formed, that we don't require the depletion region how it will be formed, that is we know already. Let's skip this point. Okay, the depletion region, the formation of depletion region, that emitter base junction, that we know already. Yeah, so let's say we don't require much about the unbiased NPN transistor. Manaku unbiased NPN transistor kante biased. So biased le em chestam most of the time, so we connect the transistor in a active mode operation. That is active mode operation manaku kavali. So unbiased anadi simply it is the understanding of the two PN junction diodes. So that I'll leave you, that you can understand yourself. That is easy to understand. So let us go for the, so what happens, yeah, that is what happens at the emitter junction diode, that's already, so those things are it is self-explanatory. The two diodes will be there, base collector junction, then how that depletion region will be formed, then like what is the process of diffusion, what is the process of drift, so how the electrons will move, how the holes will move, that vagera vagera, that all those things I'll not explain. So go to the directly, that is biased NPN transistor. That means now we give some external bias. Okay. So active mode, cutoff mode, saturation mode. So we often it will be used in the active mode, but let us make an active mode. Active mode means, so emitter and base junction will be in the forward biased. Collector and base junction will be of reverse biased. So this will be is of forward biased and this will be is of reverse biased. That's why N is connected to the negative here. The same N is connected to positive here and base will be common. Let's say for example, any one thing we need to keep the common. So, okay. Now let us see what happens here. Now let's see what happens here. This is important for me. Now let's see what happens. So now as this is a negative, it is a negative here, it is connected. That electrons will go from this place to this place. But it is very thin and lightly doped. These electrons automatically will be collected here. Okay. So that's why electrons will jump from emitter to base. So once the moment of electron will be like this, then what about the current due to these electrons? Will be in the opposite direction. So electron is here going from emitter to base. The definitely current will be from base to emitter. This by region, in case of NPN transistor, we are keeping the arrow mark will be like this. Okay, fine. Chuddam. Okkasari ekkada undi arrow mark. Ikkada undi. Yes, chudandi. So NPN transistor. NPN transistor lo arrow mark bayatiki enduku pettnam. So we are keeping from emitter to base. So emitter nunchi base ki electron elthundi. Kani current ekkada nunchi ekkada velthundi? Base to emitter current anedi elthundi. So mana current direction kavali. That is base to emitter. This is the current direction. This is the current direction arrow mark will be. Andukane aa arrow mark. So in case of NPN transistor, current will go from emitter to base. So ade PNP transistor laithe em avutundi? Emitter nunchi base ki velthundi. Ante hole a direction lo move avutundo. So hole a direction lo move avutundo. Electric current due to hole is also in the same direction. That's why it will be from emitter to base there. Okay. Artham avutunda? Okay, fine. So let us see here. Come back to the, or that is NPN transistor gurinchi nechukuntunnam. So unbiased is not that much, it is easily understandable. That is biased is important, that will be, so we connected in the active mode. Yeah. So at the base emitter junction what happens? At the emitter base junction what happens? So there is a diffusion current is also there and there is a drift current is also there. Similarly, even at a base collector junction also, there is a diffusion current as well as emission current, both will be there. Okay. So at the two junctions, it is simply the studying. So forward biased PN junction diode. So forward biased PN junction diode ni manam ela aithe study chestamo aa vidhanga study cheyadam. Similarly, collector and base junction will be reversed biased. Danni ela study chestamo exactly alage study cheyadam. So we have the diffusion currents as well as drift currents. Okay. See, that is important thing will be, we need to see what is the collector base emitter current. So that current's equation we need to write here. That I'll write simply when later on also we can understand. So the electron will move here from here to here as it is heavily doped. Remember, it will be of heavily doped. So this electron is going from this place to this place. Electrons are going. So suppose if 100 electrons are moving, going here, 99 electrons will be collected here. Suppose 100 electrons are moving, almost 90 electrons will be collected here. Okay. Now, here this is positive, will keep a large than compared to negative here. Suppose if I keep this will be, let's say this positive I keep as, say let's say for example 10 volt, this negative I will keep as 6 volt. So as a whole, this will be, holes will receive a like a positive. That means hole is connected to a positive terminal of the battery. So that means holes also moved from this place to this place. Okay. So now as it is of negative, positively, there is a positive plates, all the electrons will be automatically will be collected here. Automatically collected here. So you notice very clearly. So here the current due to emitter will be like this. So you can apply, the situation will be like this. There is a current which is coming from the emitter will be like this. And from here there is a base current will be like this. And collector current. Okay. So we can write, simple them. So emitter nunchi electrons are injected and there is a base current and there is a collector current. So IE is equal to IB plus IC will be the current equation. Remember, here in the emitter the electric current is due to majority carriers electrons and minority carriers holes. Similarly in the base also, majority carriers holes and minority carriers electrons, and all these things we combined here. So majority correct electrons and holes, the combined equation will be emitter is equal to base plus collector. This you need to remember always. So this is the current equation. So so collector collects, emitter emits. And emitter pumpichinatuvanti electrons annitni. So collector aithe collect chestundi. So in between there is a base also will be there. In base there is a holes will be there. So there is a base current is also there. Not only of collector current, there is a base current is also there. Of course charge will be conserved. Of course the charge will be conserved. Charge will be conserved. So that's why as the charge will be conserved, we are writing IE is equal to IB plus IC. So base current will be small. So IE is approximately IC generally. So this is the story of this NPN transistor. Even we can go for the PNP transistor also. Then even in the PNP transistor also, the things will be remain same. Even if we go for the PNP transistor also, it will be similar. So even in the PNP transistor, so this PNP transistor, so one will be we work for unbiased. So one will be of biased. In the biased, there are three modes will be there. Cutoff, saturation, and active mode. But important will be for me active mode. In active mode, so emitter base junction will be forward biased. So collector base junction will be is of reversed biased. So I have already explained when I connected to the biased, the current will go like this will be the forward biased and this will be the reversed biased. So in the forward biased, the holes will go like this. The hole will travel from emitter to base. This is the hole moment. Definitely emitter to base only current due to holes is also there. That's why emitter to base, that is emitter to base, the arrow mark we need to keep. The arrow mark will be emitter to base. That is, that arrow simply indicates the current direction. Okay, so not actually the charge carriers. So దాని కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఎలా చేస్తాం, sandwich n type material between two p type materials. So ion biased pnp transistor, so that is easy to understand. Unbiased pn transistor means it is simply the two diodes, pn junction diodes. One will be the forward biased diode, another one will be the reverse biased. So of course unbiased, nothing biased. When there is no bias, then we will see that there is a junction formation will be there. Junction formation will be there. So the drift current and diffusion current will be equal to each other. Then in the, that is the steady state condition we call that. So it is self-explanatory. Same thing in the P, there is a holes are the majority carriers and all those things. That I will not explain you. Once again, let us go to directly for me biased mode. Yeah, that is important for me. A PNP transistor in the biased mode. So emitter and base junction will be forward biased. That's why this P is connected to the positive here and this P is connected to the negative here. That's why it became the reverse bias. That's why it became the forward biased. Okay, now what happens at the emitter base junction? As it is a forward biased junction, it will the characteristics of forward biased, you know. Then what happens at the collector base junction? So base collector junction, that will be the reverse bias operation. This reverse bias operation mode is also, you know. So the finally we need to write the current equation as usual. Whatever the current equation we have written for the NPN transistor, the same PN will be true here. So that means, so the current from here will be is equal to this plus this. So that is emitter current will be is equal to base current plus collector current. So emitter current will be is equal to base current plus collector current. So these are important. This is the important relation. Whether it is a NPN transistor or PNP transistor, the current equation will be in the active mode. Remember, active mode of operation. Active mode IE will be is equal to IB plus IC. Okay, so these are very important things that you need to remember. So I'll stop for this session. In the next session we will see the remaining things like common emitter mode, common collector mode, common base mode, then how it will act like a amplifier. The amplification formulas will define alpha, beta, gamma of a transistor. That is important as far the examination is concerned. What is alpha of a transistor, beta of a transistor, gamma of a transistor? Then that will go for the next session. Okay, thank you. Stay home, stay safe.